So it's days until the new MacBook Pro 16-inch with a possible M1X inside will be announced. However, today, a sketchy report has come in that the new design for the MacBook Pros will have a notch with Face ID like an iPhone. Today, let's review this report and share the latest on the 2021 new MacBook Pro 16-inch release date and price. So, it's October time, and we're now on the final run to the next Apple event, where we're most likely going to see some brand new MacBook Pros. Going forwards, I've decided for all the new MacBook Pro 16-inch videos like this one you are watching, I am going to give you the latest details on specific reports or info that has been told, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the models that we're going to get, and also the features that we have learnt in previous leaks, and also the prices. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the MacBook Pro 16-inch. Also, put in the comments below what features you'd love to see in the new MacBook Pro, and in my next video, I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So, let's review this report of a MacBook Pro having a notch design on it. So even though we are so close to the new MacBook Pro 16-inch and 14-inch release, a new report has claimed that the MacBook Pro will get a notch on the design with Face ID. The report has come from a Weibo user who has said the MacBook Pro will feature this in the design, and this is why, for example, the 16-inch MacBook Pro has more pixels on its display than its last generation design. However, it is a very sketchy report with no finer details than other mentioning about the notch itself. Personally for me, I think it's untrue, as if you've opened up an iPhone or an iPad Pro with Face ID inside, you will know that the sensors go almost to the back of the casing, and if the new MacBooks were to have the sensor set up inside it in the lid screen, it's going to be a very thick one on top of the new MacBook Pros to hold these sensors inside, and this would be a very backwards move from Apple. So in my opinion, I do not believe this is to be true from my point of view. However, we could be surprised on the release. But do let me know your thoughts in the comments on this one. This also leads me on nicely to say that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof that they're going to come true with the new MacBooks. I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you're watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the new MacBooks anyway. So then, release date. A lot of reports out there tell us that the MacBook Pro 14 and 16-inch models are planned to be seen at the new October Unleashed event in just a few days' time. If this is the case, then we believe pre-orders for the new Macs will start on Friday, October 22nd, with the Macs in people's hands a week later on October 29th. However, I would say this, we have witnessed in the last year or so quite a few Apple products that have not been released straight away, like the iPad Pro, the M1 iMac, and also recently the new Apple Watch Series 7. All three of these were released over 4 weeks later after the Apple event that they were announced at. One last point to talk about for these new Macs as well is a lot of people keep referring to the chipset name as the M1X. However, there actually hasn't been a single report to confirm this is going to be the case. So Apple may call this chipset the M2 or even a totally different name altogether. But until the official name is revealed, in this video, I'll refer to it as the M1X until we have confirmation of the name. So then guys, just quickly, this channel got over 260,000 subscribers, and I announced who the winner was for this brand new iPad Pro M1. And do check out my video on my channel of who this iPad Pro is going to. But the great news is guys, I am doing another giveaway, and it is for this. It is for a brand new iPhone 13 Pro Max 128GB model in the Sierra Blue. And I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 300,000 subscribers. And just like the last giveaway, what I want you guys to do is put down in the comments below of what Apple gear you're planning to buy in 2021 or maybe into 2022. Also at the same time, make sure you subscribe to this button, hit that notification bell, because when we get over 300,000 subscribers, I will be notifying you guys of who the winner is of this brand new iPhone. And just quickly on that, I do want to quickly comment that if you do get a comment to say that you've won or something like this before we hit the 300,000 marker, it is probably not me. It is most likely a scammer. And the best way you can tell if this is a scammer or not is basically open up that person's account by clicking on their profile, and you'll be able to see how many subscribers they got. And if they've got less than 260,000 subscribers, like at the time I'm making this video here, then basically you will know they are not me. Plus, also at the same time as well, they will probably have hardly any videos uploaded, and also their account will probably be very, very new. So do ignore these emails or these messages from these people, or what you can do is at the same time, you can actually report them to YouTube. But enough of that. Like I said, over 300,000 subscribers is the only time I'm going to be announcing who the winner is of this iPhone 13 Pro Max, and that's the only prize I'm going to be doing between now and then. So make sure you subscribe to this channel, hit that notification bell. Also at the same time, guys, if you're liking this video so far, please do press the like button. Well, let's get back to the main video. With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far of previous leaks that have painted the picture of the details for the MacBook Pro 16-inch with its price as well. So these are the facts of what we know about the MacBook Pro 16-inch, and of course this could change over time, so make sure you do check out my videos in the future. But anyway, we're expecting a 16-inch XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display. This is very similar to the display that we find in the iPad Pro 12.9-inch, and it will feature a resolution of 3072 by 1920, exactly what we get in the standard LED display in the current MacBook Pro 16-inch. However, the difference is most likely we're going to be getting ProMotion 120Hz refresh rate with this. On top, for storage options, they will start from 512GB all the way up to 8TB of storage. Then most likely we're going to be getting our M1X chipset inside it, what will be a 12-core CPU, and also will feature a 16 or 32-core GPU option depending on the amount of RAM that you pick. And talk about RAM, the options of RAMs will be 16GB, 32GB or 64GB of RAM. It is most likely that the 32-core GPU option will be available with 32 or 64GB of RAM. We're also going to be getting a brand new design with the MacBook Pro 16-inch, and it will be made out of an aluminium body. And you've seen this new design and what it could potentially look like in the renders in this video. For ports, MagSafe is back at last, but at the same time as well, we'll be getting three USB-C ports, and these will be Thunderbolt 4 ports. That's one less than what we get on the MacBook Pro right now, but we will get the return of HDMI 2.1 and also an SD card slot. At the same time, the webcam in the center is going to be that new center stage webcam that will be a 12 megapixel camera. The battery life from the latest leaks that we've been told will be an 8,693 milliamp. So for prices, because things can be a bit of a mix-up depending on what options you pick, I've based this on the lowest amount of RAM what you can get and then going up in the storage amounts. So the prices will start at $2,399 for a 512GB option, for 1TB, $2,099, 2TB, $2,999, 4TB, $3,599, and 8TB, $4,799. So that is a summary of the MacBook Pro 16-inch. However, for my thoughts and wishes, my wish is actually to do with the price. Now, over the years, the 16-inch MacBook Pro has gone up and has creeped up quite a bit. So the current base model now starts at $2,400, and if we go back just around that 8 years ago, it started at $1,800. I am hoping that Apple can at least keep the same price and not increase the cost of the next generation MacBook Pro 16-inch. But let me know your thoughts if you agree with this or not, and write in the comments below your wishes what you'd like to see in the new MacBook Pro 16-inch. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, see you soon.